Hello and welcome to another episode of Science Monitor, a show that brings to you the most significant news from the world of science, technology, innovation, research, discoveries and much more. I'm Aishwarya Kapoor and here are this week's headlines. ISRO successfully places CartoSat 2 series satellite into orbit along with 30 small satellites using the PSLV C-40 launch vehicle from Sriharikota. India's fastest and first multi-petaflop supercomputer inaugurated at IITM Pune by Dr. Harshvardhan, Union Minister for Science and Technology and Earth Sciences. Third stage for Indian National Mathematical Olympiad to be held on 21st of January 2018 in 30 centres across the country. Indian National Science Academy Fellow awarded to Professor Rajendra Singh Sangwan for exemplary work on medicinal and aromatic plants. Our top story. This week, ISRO successfully launched the CartoSat 2 series satellite using the PSLV C-40 from the spaceport in Sriharikota in Andhra Pradesh. The primary objective of CartoSat 2 is to provide high-resolution, scene-specific spot imageries. This is the third satellite in the CartoSat 2 series. This mission also saw the launch of 30 small satellites. 28 of these are from foreign countries, including Finland and the United States of America. Our team at Science Monitor brings you this report.
The Indian Space Research Organization, or ISRO, successfully launched its CartoSat 2 series Earth Observation spacecraft and 30 small satellites using PSLV C-40 on 12th 2018. The launch took place from Sriharikota, Andhra Pradesh. The payload included one nano and one micro satellite from India and 28 other satellites from foreign countries including Finland and the United States. The two small Indian satellites are Microsat and Nanosat, which are technology demonstrators. The CartoSat 2 satellite was a follow-on mission of this series with the primary objective of providing high-resolution, scene-specific spot imageries. The satellite carried panchromatic and multispectral cameras, which takes black and white pictures of the Earth. The total area covered by the advanced camera is 9.6 km and the spatial resolution is less than 1 meter.
ISRO is starting 2018 with the successful launch of our CartoSat small satellite, nanosat, and also microsat, and 28 customer satellites. So far, the CartoSat performance, as already announced by the project director, is satisfactory, and we will follow up on the remaining satellite performance. And this year, we have a large number of activities planned, and the next GSLV Mark II is already getting assembled, and it's scheduled for launch next month.
The CartoSat 2 satellite is the third Earth observation satellite of the CartoSat series and will provide images for cartographic, urban and rural applications, coastal land use and regulation and utility management like road network monitoring, water distribution, creation of land use maps, precision study, change detection to bring out geographical and man-made features, and various other land information system and geographical information system applications. This is the first space mission of 2018 using Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle or PSLV after the unsuccessful launch of navigational satellite IRNSS-1H. The first 3 months of 2018 will be a busy quarter for the Indian Space Organization, as after the CartoSat 2 launch, ISRO is ready to launch GSAT-6A and GSAT-29. The much-awaited Chandrayaan 2 mission is also scheduled to launch in the first half of 2018.
India's fastest and first multi-petaflop supercomputer was dedicated to the nation by Union Minister of Earth Sciences Dr. Harshvardhan on 8th of January 2018. The supercomputer, named as the Pratyush, meaning the sun, has been established at the Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, Pune. And the supercomputer will be used for improving weather and climate forecasts and services under the umbrella of the Ministry of Earth Sciences, Government of India. With the augmentation of new Pratyush, high-performance computing facility of 6.8 petaflops India's ranking will move from the 368th position to around the top 30 in the top 500 list of HPC facilities in the world. Science Monitor team brings you this report.
Computers have revolutionized human life to every possible extent. From solving tedious algorithms to lengthy calculations, from artificial intelligence to robotics, computers have been providing all the answers to our question. But in order to solve extremely complex scientific and engineering algorithms, which requires handling of very large databases to perform great amount of computation, these normal computers fail to serve the purpose. That's when we look out for a supercomputer. A supercomputer is a computer with a high level of computing performance as compared to a general purpose computer. A standard computer can process information at a speed of millions instructions per second, or MIPS, which is currently around 304,510 MIPS, while a supercomputer's performance capability is measured in floating points operations per second, or FLOPS. Floating point is a method of encoding extremely long numbers so that they can be handled easily. A supercomputer is not simply a fast or a very large computer. Instead of doing one thing at a time, it does many things at once. Supercomputers play an important role in the field of computational science and are used in various fields like quantum mechanics, weather forecasting, climate research, oil and gas exploration, and physical simulations such as early moments of universe, airplane and spacecraft aerodynamics, detonation of nuclear weapons, and nuclear fusion. India's fastest and first multi-petaflop supercomputer was unveiled at Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, Pune. Was inaugurated by Dr. Harshvardhan, Union Minister for Science and Technology, Earth Sciences and Environment, Forest and Climate Change. The supercomputer named Pratyush, meaning the sun, will be able to perform 6.8 thousand trillion operations per second, which is symbolized by 6.8 petaflops, which is way beyond the capacity of a normal computer. Pratyush will be India's best high-performance computing facility in terms of peak capacity and performance, which will be kept in the National Facility for Improving Weather and Climate Forecasts and Services under the umbrella of Ministry of Earth Sciences or MoES, Government of India.
ये आने वाले समय के अंदर जो हमारे बड़े मिशन्स हैं, जैसे नेशनल मॉनसून मिशन के माध्यम से हम ब्लॉक लेवल तक इस साल के अंत में या समझ लीजिए 2019 के अंदर निश्चित रूप से ब्लॉक लेवल हम फोरकास्ट करने वाले हैं किसानों के लिए जो है.
India needs better forecasts for weather and climate conditions like monsoon, extreme events like tsunamis, cyclones, earthquakes, air quality, lightning, hot or cold waves, and flood or drought, etc. To provide all such forecast and prediction services, high-performance computing facilities are required. For this, Ministry of Earth Sciences has set up models like high-resolution rapid refresh and couple forecast systems, which are run only on supercomputers. So there is a constant need of enhancing the performance and upgrading the speed of these supercomputers to achieve more accurate weather predictions. Ministry of Earth Sciences stands tall in the international weather and climate sciences community and constantly endeavors to provide the best services to the country. Presently, with around 1 petaflop peak capacity, India's ranking in high performance computing or HPC is much below than the HPC rankings of major countries which generate weather or climate forecasts. With Pratyush's high performance computing facility of 6.8 petaflops, India's ranking will move from 368th position to the top 30s among the 500 list of HPC facilities in the world. India will also be placed at 4th position after UK, Japan and USA for dedicated high-performance computing resources for weather or climate community. The new supercomputer is installed at two institutes under the Ministry of Earth Sciences, the 4.0 petaflops high-performance computing facility at Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, Pune, and 2.8 petaflops facility, which is to be set at National Center for Medium-Range Weather Forecasting, Noida.
It's time for a short break, but when we return, we take you to Mumbai, where preparations are underway for the upcoming Mathematical Olympiad. Keep watching Science Monitor.
landslides are predictable, preventable, and controllable, provided you have the scientific bent of mind in looking at it. We talk about prediction of those landslides which are every year occurring. It's the water pressures, the poor drainage, which is the cause of flood. India must have its own agreed, standardized, uniform classification system, methodologies of hazard mapping and all that. Without it, we can't understand anything.
Watch Eureka with Dr. Rajendra Kumar Bhandari, Chairman, Forum for Disaster Mitigation at India National Academy of Engineers, New Delhi, only on Rajya Sabha Television.
The Mathematical Olympiad is an initiative to identify mathematical talent among school students and to train them to achieve excellence at the international level. The Olympiad, organized by the Homi Bhabha Center for Science Education with the National Board for Higher Mathematics, aims to inculcate a better understanding of mathematics among school children across the country. The third stage of the Olympiad will be held on the 21st of January 2018.
The Mathematical Olympiad program is organized by the Homi Bhabha Center for Science Education, or HBCSC, on behalf of the National Board for Higher Mathematics, or NBHM, of the Department of Atomic Energy, or DAE. The program aims to identify mathematical talent among pre-university students in India. For training and selection of students, 25 regions all over the country have designated and assigned a regional coordinator with three groups: Central Board of Secondary Education, Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti, and Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan. The candidate aspiring to apply for the Mathematical Olympiad must be an Indian citizen. They must be born on or after August 1, 1998. In addition, they must be in class 8th, 9th, 10th, or 11th. The syllabus for the Mathematical Olympiad comprises of pre-university mathematics. Major areas covered are arithmetic of integers, geometry, quadratic equations, algebra, and number theory.
The main thing that they learn is they learn how to respond to a challenging situation, which they normally don't face in school. And the long-term benefit is that in India we have two institutes, like the Chennai Mathematical Institute and Indian Statistical Institute, who offer direct admission to the students who qualify for the camp. That is the fourth stage of the program. So that is how they benefit, and those who are really motivated to pursue a career in mathematics, they take up admission in one of these institutes and pursue a career in mathematics, and they do well in their career in future.
To participate in the International Mathematical Olympiad, the candidate has to clear first five stages. The first stage involves pre-regional mathematical olympiad, or PRMO. From this, around 300 students are selected to write the regional mathematical olympiad exam. The Indian Association of Physics Teachers, or IAPT, conducts the first stage of the olympiad. Stage 2, the regional mathematical olympiad, or RMO, consists of descriptive questions. Stage 3, called the International Mathematical Olympiad, or INMO, is organized at 30 centers across India. This stage comprises of descriptive questions. The INMO exam will be held on January 21, 2018. Stage 4 of the Olympiad is the International Mathematical Olympiad, or IMO, training camp organized by HBCSC. This involves lecture and problem-solving sessions. Stage 5 is the pre-departure camp with lecture and problem-solving sessions. Stage 6 is the final stage of the Olympiad, where 6 students are selected for the international venue with the problem-solving competition. These stages are also applicable for students who are willing to participate in European Girls Mathematical Olympiad, or EGMO, and Asian Specific Mathematics Olympiad, or APMO. For further information, the candidate can visit the website olympiad.hbcse.tifr.res.in. The Mathematical Olympiad will help students advance in fields of mathematics, which will encourage them to take up this subject in future for further studies. This platform will also provide an international platform for the young students to widen their knowledge by interacting with students from across the globe.
To promote science in India, the Indian National Science Academy confers the title of Fellow to esteemed researchers every year to honor their contribution in the national growth and social welfare. The INSA has elected 31 fellows from across the country for this honor. Science Monitor will bring you a special series to introduce the work being done by these scientists. This week, we'll meet Professor Rajendra Singh Sangwan, who has received this title for his lifelong work on medicinal and aromatic plants.
To promote science in India and to harness scientific knowledge for humanity and social welfare, the Indian National Science Academy, INSA, was established in 1935. The Academy has instituted awards in 68 different categories of science for esteemed researchers from all across the country. INSA has awarded the prestigious title of Fellow for 2018 to 31 scientists from diverse fields of science. One amongst the prestigious INSA Fellow is Professor Rajendra Singh Sangwan, Director of Academy of Scientific and Innovative Research, ACSIR, in Ghaziabad, Uttar Pradesh, who enjoys a tall standing in the area of plant sciences. Till date, he has worked with many native and medicinally important plants of India. His most exemplary work is on a plant called Ashwagandha.
We propose that they work on Ashwagandha so that this plant be the most popular or important Indian medicinal plant. But there was no science which was done. We know about it. But when we are strong in its use, we must be also strong in its science. We worked on this plant for 15 years. And today, this is the Indian medicinal plant, probably the Indian medicinal plant in which we have the best of science which has been made available.
Plants gives us many life-sustaining products like food, oxygen and timber. Some plants also give us medicinally important products. Tulsi, haldi, ginger, garlic and muleti are few examples of plants which have proven health benefits. Ashwagandha is another medicinally important plant in Ayurveda. There are many scientific studies to show that it increases physical endurance in rat models. Rat fed with ashwagandha extract swim for a longer duration in swimming test compared to control rats. It also helps to manage arthritis, diabetes, high blood pressure and tumors and regulates immune system as per some studies. The name Ashwagandha is a combination of the word Ashwa, meaning horse, and Gandha, meaning smell, reflecting that its root has a strong horse-like odor. Its scientific name is Withania somnifera. It is found in many states of India, including Madhya Pradesh, Punjab, Kerala, Rajasthan, and Haryana. Professor Sangwan, along with his team, have studied the constituents, diversity, and medicinal effects of Ashwagandha. In his studies, he identified 62 different secondary metabolites from leaves and 48 from roots of Ashwagandha. Secondary metabolites are special compounds found in some plants that are not directly involved in normal growth, development or reproduction, but have other uses like inhibiting growth of bacteria or microbes. Of all identified compounds, the most abundant compound in Ashwagandha was a molecule named Withafrin A. They did further research on Withafrin A and showed that it inhibits abnormal divisions of immune cells. This implied that it was beneficial for health. In 2009, Professor Sangwan's team distributed Ashwagandha seeds to farmers on the occasion of CSIR Foundation Day. The code name of this plant variety was 118. His team found that its extract was useful for treating brain stroke. In the future, Professor Sangwan's team plans to explore the uses of other important molecules such as withanones and withanolides, which they also found in Ashwagandha in their study. Professor Sangwan is delighted that his work has been recognized and is humbled to receive the title of INSA Fellow. Professor Sangwan graduated from Kurukshetra University in Haryana and did an MSc and PhD in science from the Haryana Agriculture University. He worked as a scientist at the Central Institute of Medicinal and Aromatic Plants, CIMAP, Lucknow, for almost 26 years and was the founder chief executive officer of the Center of Innovative and Applied Bioprocessing, CIAB, an autonomous institute under Department of Biotechnology, Government of India, situated in Mohali, Punjab. For his work, Professor Rajendra Sangwan has won many awards, including the CSIR Technology Award in Life Sciences 2015, CSIR Leadership Development Program 2008, Professor Umakant Sinha Memorial Award 1997, and CSIR Young Scientist Award in 1993. He plans to do in-depth research on native Indian plants to find which molecules in them are medicinally important. This scientific evidence will help to strengthen traditional Indian knowledge, which could open new avenues in the field of plant and health sciences in our country.
It's time for a short break, and when we come back, we bring you some more news on science and innovation from India and around the world. But that's after a short break, so keep watching Science Monitor.
The Indian Institute of Management Bill 2017.
All these Indian Institute of Management postgraduate diploma holders face many difficulties world over while registering for PhDs and other research facilities because it is not a degree, it's a diploma. Ab inko jab ye national importance ka status milega, to ye degree de sakenge.
Before I was elected to this August House, for 14 years, I had the privilege of being a faculty member at the Indian Institute of Management, Bangalore.
Yeah.
So it is a matter of great pride and joy to see a bill coming through to elevate the status of not only IIM Bangalore, but other Indian Institutes of Management to status of institutions of national importance.
Creating an institution, I mean building the structure of the institution in bricks and mortars is comparatively easy. But to inculcate a very vibrant institutional life in an institution is very difficult. And I believe autonomy plays a key role in the art of institution building.
Welcome back after the break. Let's now take a quick look at some more scientific innovations and developments from India and around the world.
NASA will launch two missions to explore the ionosphere, a little understood region of the Earth's upper atmosphere. These layers or near-Earth space are increasingly becoming a part of human domain as it is home to signals used to guide airplanes, ships, and global positioning system satellites. The two missions are titled Icon and Gold. The global scale observations of the LIMB and DISC Gold mission will be launched aboard a commercial communication satellite in January 2018, and the designed spacecraft Ionosphere Connection Explorer, or Icon, will be launched later in this year. Once declared endangered in the red list of the IUCN, International Union for the Conservation of Nature, and considered at the brink of extinction, population of the bird Narcondem hornbills, scientifically known as Rhytiseros narcondami, is gradually flourishing as per a study done by the Zoological Survey of India in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Scientists could spot nearly 80 breeding pairs of Narcondem hornbill, which has brought cheer to ecologists and researchers. A rare total lunar eclipse that falls on the second full moon of the month, popularly referred to as Blue Moon, can be seen on January 31st. It is the first blue moon of 2018 for the Indian subcontinent, the Middle East and Eastern Europe. The eclipse will already be underway as the moon rises. Scientists from the National Center for Biological Sciences, or NCBS, Bengaluru, and the Okinawa Institute of Science and Technology Graduate University, Japan, have discovered two new species of endemic ants from Andaman and Nicobar Islands and published their findings in the journal PJ. The scientific names of these ants are Tetramorium krishnani and Tetramorium jarava. These ants were found to dwell on the leaf litter of evergreen forest of Havelock Islands. The town of Ain Sefra, located at the edge of Sahara Desert, saw snowfall last week. It is estimated that this has happened third time in the last 40 years. Snowfall is rare in the region, but no one knows how rare, as the desert is vast and there are comparatively few monitoring facilities. The snow fell in the Sahara at altitudes of more than 3,000 feet, where temperatures are low. The desert sees extreme temperatures during the day and night. The reason for the snow is the cold air blowing in from the North Atlantic.
And in the history of science, we remember Indian biochemist Hargobind Khurana, born on 9th of January 1922 in Raipur, now in Pakistan. He did outstanding work in the field of biochemistry. He primarily carried out research in human genetics and experimented on nucleic acid present in RNA. Khurana shared the Nobel Prize for Physiology in 1968 with Marshall W. Nirenberg and Robert W. Hole for research that demonstrated how the genetic information is translated into proteins. Along with this, he also researched on phosphate esters and organophosphate that are the bases of insecticides and herbicides. He constructed the first ever artificial gene in 1972 and made the artificial gene function in a bacteria cell. Khurana also studied the structure and function of rhodopsin, a light-sensitive protein found in the eye. Hargobind Khurana passed away on 9th of November 2011 at the age of 89. His initial discovery in the field of human genetics still proves to be the benchmark for many studies even today. Well, that is all for this episode of Science Monitor. You can send your feedback and suggestions to Science Monitor on our email ID news@viganprasar.gov.in. You can also write in to us at Vigyan Prasar, C24 Kutub Institutional Area, New Delhi 110016. We'll see you again next week with another episode of Science News and Innovations. Till then, goodbye and take care.